with my old friend, Mose Anderson. Say, Mose, how are you coming on today?
Oh, I am coming on kind of scandamanavious.
Mm-hmm. What you doing for a living now?
I'm an agent.
Agent? Agent for what?
Insect powder.
Insect powder?
Yes, you want to buy some of this powder?
Why, no, I don't want any powder.
Does your mother want to buy some of this powder?
My poor mother is dead.
Mm-hmm. If she was alive, you think she'd need some of this powder?
Look here, Mose, don't talk about my mother in that manner. I don't like it.
No harm done.
No, but there will be if you don't quit.
But good day. Good day, sir.
Good day. But say, Mose, just a moment.
Oh, I know that you'd want some of this powder, Lord.
No, I hardly think I need any. But tell me, how is this powder used?
It's very simple, very simple. I'll tell you how you use it. You get up about 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning when everything is quiet and still.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You've got a lamp in your right hand and some powder in the other. You sneak downstairs in your stocking feet until you come to the kitchen.
To the kitchen?
Mm-hmm. Then you look all around the room until you see a roach or a bug. And when you see a bug, you flash the lamp in the bug's eyes until you hypnotize him.
Hypnotize the bug?
And then you chase him 4 or 5 times around the room until the bug sweats.
Oh, Lord.
Until he's all exhausted. Then you stoop down, grab him by the back of the neck, betwixt the forefinger and the thumb.
Mm-hmm.
And you choke him till he's black in the face, until he opens his mouth about a foot wide. Then you take a shovel full of this powder and ram it down the bug's throat, and when you get him chucked full of powder, you slam him down on the floor, jump on him, and the bug is dead.
Well, for 5 minutes, have I been compelled to stand here and listen to that unmitigated, unsophisticated, nonsensical bunch of jargon that has just emanated from that concrete mass of asphalt? Why, you ebony son of Ham, why didn't you do that in the first place?
You cussing me? You cussing me? I don't allow nobody to say them cuss words to me.
As you are stepping from the physiological to the psychological, from the body and mind to the spirit. And wherever there's a superfluity of ocratism spreading devastation with altruistic discrimination, then, and not till then, will the subdivision transcendentalism assert itself. I say, Moe, you're some laugher.
Yes, and I'm a smiler, too.
Well, say, I'm going down to a party this evening. Suppose we run over our old-time laughing song, and I'll take you with me.
I'll sail with you.
We met a girl this afternoon, dressed up like a girl, with a bust as big as a water tank and no one upon a wall. So she says, "You darling boy, my baby and my pet, and the way you smile so smolingly, I never shall forget." She was such a dandy. Sweetest laugh of candy. Over feet of dandy. Dandy, candy, dandy.